Hello, folks, and welcome to the first installment of a series that I'm going to start doing here on my YouTube channel, which will just be documenting my training for strongman stuff. I'm about 10 weeks out from Strongman Corp Nationals, and that's going to be like the bulk of what these videos are going to be about for the next 10 weeks. Then after that, I'm sure I'll just document whatever else is going on. The reason why I wanted to start doing this is I think filming and documenting more of my training will be a good way to analyze my own training myself, just from a different angle, as opposed to just kind of posting the stuff that I like on Instagram. I'm just going to kind of look through it all. The other reason why I wanted to start doing this is I think genuinely there might be an audience out there that wants to see different approaches to training. Not to say that I'm like this insanely unique athlete, but I will say like the more content that's out there for people involved in the sport, the better, because then you get to see like the wide spectrum of how people go about training for this unique sport. So there's already a lot of good content out there, and I'm hoping that I could just kind of add to that and maybe entertain some people. I want to keep it fun. I want to keep it cool. I really enjoy training, and I want to show kind of how much I enjoy training, how much I enjoy the process. I don't know if I'm going to do a vlog for every training session, but I'm going to do vlogs, basically. I'll probably start doing this on like my real camera right now. This is just on my phone. But you know, if you're watching, give me a little holler and let me know what else you want to see. Yeah, so squat day today. I'm going to do some Conan's wheels, sandbag throws, and then accessory work. And yeah, cool. All right, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. All right, I'm going to add a voiceover to this because why not? These are front squats here. Doing front squats is really nice. I tend to get a lot out of it. It's just as far as promoting like the upright posture you need for a lot of strongman movements, you know, front carries, Atlas stone load, stuff like that. Also kind of keeps weight off the spine, which is sometimes pretty nice for strongman. At Lightning Fitness, there's a lot of really good specialty barbells there that Matt has. And this one is a specific front squat bar, and I really like it a lot. So it looks strange, and it looks like it might be uncomfortable with that bar right in front of my neck, but it's actually not touching my neck, so it's not limiting any breathing or anything. And with the handles where they are, it really promotes to have that upright position kind of like perfectly. And like a high elbow position, really good for log press, getting used to stuff like that. But all in all, it's just really good for my leverages on squat. Like for front squat specifically, I'm able to get quite deep with it. It's good. It's a very good bar. And so, yeah, these front squats felt good today. They felt like they should. 375 for sets of five. I showed two of the sets. I'm not showing all of them. That would just be redundant for the video, but weight is moving good. Not really hammering the squats like too intensely just yet, but it builds up, it accumulates over time, and it helps with literally everything else. So yeah.
Yeah.
All right, now I'm trying to be entertaining. I don't know if I'm being entertaining. Let me know if I'm being entertaining. I have Conan's wheel now to work up to a top set of two spins. And I think this will be the working way. I think it's like 450 or something. I don't know. I'll do the math after. Yeah, so this feels kind of good. Posture feels good with the implement right now, but it started slipping out of my hands, and I didn't really want to just carry it with my biceps. I'm a little mad here. I'm a little disappointed because I really was confident I could do two revolutions, but I didn't. I'm gonna try it again. Ross told me to try it again. He told me to try it again, so I'm doing it again.
All right, here's my second attempt here. I'm gonna try and get 2 revolutions with it. Same weight, keeping it at 450 or whatever. I didn't count it. I think it's either 450 or 460. Honestly, that doesn't matter, whatever. my goal here is I wanted to lean back more. And so I definitely did there. Had a slow start with it, but was able to move a lot quicker than the other set. And I'm taking better strides. It just feels like it's in a better rack position. And it's starting to slide again here, and then I drop it. So, yeah. Then Ross runs over, and he's like, I figured it out. Here's what you did. And,
bending over it like this.
Here's what I did.
And then trying to extend.
Yes.
You should be
forward.
And then extend. Like, hips shoot. Look at my hips. Hips here. So you were doing that, right?
Yeah.
But your feet were back here, and when you extended, as soon as you moved, it brought you forward. So, now. Get them. Or.
You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did, you have to move. You have to stay in that position. Yeah. So what you did,
feet.
Okay.
So that when you start walking, it doesn't bring you forward. So it may be like a yoke thing, right? Where like slow and then accelerate.
Yes.
Maybe. I don't know. I've never done this. Just
yeah. You're right.
Think your back.
Yeah.
But you're actually upright. So when you walk, it's gonna go like this.
Yeah, because if I'm behind it, I'll dump forward. Okay. You're now in the block, too.
I think this is entertaining. Is this entertaining? I hope that's helpful information. That was helpful for me. Shout out. Shout out to Ross for the help. Shout out.
I think this is entertaining.
Oh, sweet. Now we got Sean. Sean doing the turn. He's looking right at, oh my God. What a showman. Wow. You know, gang, I think this is turning out to be an entertaining vlog. All right. The second run on the cones wheel felt better. It felt a lot better, actually. Positioning for my arms was better, but what Ross just said was right, is my feet were behind the bar, so when I picked it, it would dump forward. So next time, feet ahead of the bar to have less dump forward. All right, I'm gonna do sandbag throws next. Thunder rumbling right now. I don't know if it's safe. It's not insanely hot out like it's been. 16 feet. We're gonna throw some back. Entertaining. I don't know if I'm being entertaining enough. You have to put on like a comedy routine or something. Tell jokes. I'm funny. I am funny. But like if I gotta force it, it's not that funny. I don't know. I'm doing singles with the 60 pound. So a few singles
Hopefully get it over the 16 feet a few times. More than a few. God damn it. Is that high enough? I'm not explosive right now.
I don't like this. Thanks, bro. Thank you. We're close.
What a bitch.
You didn't see my first like 20 attempts with 60.
Well, it doesn't matter what you say you did.
Well, it's on camera and they all sucked.
Yo, how the fuck, dude? I tried to adjust this the other day.
Tip it over.
That's what I thought.
Mm-hmm. All right. Kind of not thrilled with the sandbag throws, but whatever. I'm going to do my leg accessories now. Safety bar, split squats, and leg press, and some core. Split squats took the life out of me. Makes sense, you know, I'm over 400 pounds. But effective exercise, good leg pump, get a little leg press now, but quite tired. Yeah, making it work though. I hope this is entertaining. If this, I know I said this like a bunch of times, but like, I'm gonna make these videos. I just want to make them good, you know?
I'm just going to talk during this portion of the video to make the leg presses less boring. These are just leg presses, nothing to it. I actually did them quite light. The sled on this one from Elite FTS is like super heavy anyway, so a little weight goes a long way. Peep the mobility, the hip mobility on the fella, quite low. Impressive, I know. This was third set of leg presses. I just try to keep the accessory work quick but effective, good execution of reps, and limited rest periods. Just kind of, you know, building that conditioning and not wasting time, doing good reps, effective reps, and that's it. Getting out of that thing for me, you know, whatever. What do you expect? This portion of the video is solely here to prove that I do my accessory work and as an accountability thing for myself to not sandbag accessory work. I fast forwarded this and I cropped out the middle part of the planking because like nobody really wants to watch a minute of me planking, but I'm putting this in here to say that it's important to do your core work and that if you skip your core work, you're a loser. I once was a loser that skipped his core work and I no longer skip my core work. Self-accountability is important, people.
All right, I'm done. I don't know how I'm gonna wrap up this video, but I'm just gonna go off the top of my head here. I guess the point of the series is about being candid. So if I'm being completely candid right now, like this was just a fine session. Squats moved the way they were supposed to. Conan's wheel felt better than it has in the past, but still not perfect. So a lot to work on, a lot to look forward to. Ross had said to me, like, you're going to get to a point where it just clicks and that's like the good feeling that you're looking for. That's just not happening yet. So I'm just waiting, you know. And in all honesty, I'm like waiting for my sandbag throws to click again. So I know how I have the capability to get 60 pounds over 16 feet. I think a couple weeks ago, I got 60 pounds over 16 feet. So I can do that. I'm better at sandbag now. I'm just not like as good as I want to be. And I'm still working on it. I'm, you know, figuring it out and I'm waiting for it to click. So if that's the theme right now of this part of my training, these two events specifically, then I guess I'm just waiting for it to click, which is fine. That's the whole point of this process of training is you keep coming in, you keep getting the reps in, and you get better. It just doesn't happen instantly. So was that too theatrical, me doing like the snap and saying instantly? I felt that was corny, but that's just what my mind told me to do, and that's what I did there. So I don't know. I'm not really trying to be a showman here, but I do want to make these videos entertaining. With that said, thanks for watching. I'm going to put this video together. I'm going to edit this and then put it on youtube.com/AntBalzano. I think that's what it is. And also post it, the link to it on Instagram at AntBalzano. And then I'm going to, should I LinkedIn? Should I put this on the LinkedIn? Do people want to see? And okay, thanks for watching. Bye.